Today I'm going to talk about objectivity in social sciences. As we know that objectivity in social sciences is very difficult to achieve in social sciences, and because of that, objectivity was actually not part of the social science research before the 20th century. But when in 20th century, when social sciences start scientific research, normally objectivity also became part of it. And many of the social sciences research after that was very much objective in nature, with its limitations. There are a lot of limitations assigned to it that we can discuss later. So when objectivity was introduced in social science research, the perception was that the general perception that existed up to that period was that social sciences cannot be objective because of its inherent nature. But the researches in 20th centuries proved that objectivity is possible in social science research too, especially with that of positivism of Auguste Comte. And Comte himself proposed basically a shift from social philosophy to social science, and positivism that thereby gave greater stress on the immediate sensory experience and the data observed. So according to this positivist school of thought, the experience was the only reliable source of human knowledge, and thus based on real life experiences they started developing theories and made scientific explanations just like that of the science subject. So the objective of this attempt was to take control of the dramatic changes in all spheres of life and make possible suggestions to improve the safe, to improve the human life. So objectivity is often considered as an ideal for scientific inquiry, as a good reason for valuing scientific knowledge, and as a basis of authority of science in society, where social sciences lag behind the sciences because of the absence of the objectivity. And that is why the social scientists made an attempt to bring objectivity in social sciences. So the basic assumption is that the social sciences should not be influenced by particular perspectives, value commitments, community bias, or personal interests while doing their research. So the unleaving of prejudices is considered to be the hallmark of the scientific method, which actually brought into the social sciences too. So the demand of objectivity is basically to relinquish all ideas and notions that arise as a result of individual biases and preconceptions. So the conclusion should be independent of one's own personal beliefs, likes, dislikes, and hopes. So the both the data and inferences drawn from their analysis must be free from all these individual biases and prejudices. And for this purpose, to achieve this, ceaseless observation is a must. Or that is, ceaseless observations on recurrent phenomena is that constitute one of the important method of this social science research. Also, the social facts should be considered as things that can be studied, just as like in the science. So while observing the social facts, all preconception must be eradicated, and the researcher needs to free from all kind of prejudices and biases. But at the same time, we know that however the social scientists try to bring a kind of objectivity in social sciences, they face a lot of challenges because of the inherent human nature. And some people argued that features like predictions based on probability, then exclusion of value judgments, search for all evidence that's relevant to the problem are actually not possible in physical which are actually possible in physical sciences, but which is not possible in social sciences. So objectivity is a kind of impossibility in social sciences. So there are a lot of limitations inherent to the social science subjects to bring objectivity in it. But so we can just say which are those limitations that arise while doing a social science research. And the first limitation itself is that social science scientist is a part of the society. The person who actually start the research, the person who intend to do the research itself is part of the society. So he can also be influenced by the value judgments, the perception norms, and the culture and the systems that is that exist in the society. So he can be influenced by all these factors. So it is very difficult to keep an unbiased mind while doing the research. So the personal values of the researcher is shaped and occurred according to the culture and norms in the society. So he can also be with a prejudiced mind he can do the research, which may finally affect the research results. So all these temperamental weaknesses, then skeptical attitude, wishful thinking, vested interest, all these plays while doing the social science research. Then another problem that we can say is a complexity of the subject matter. When we select a topic for the research in social sciences, we know that the topic itself is very complex in nature. So it is very difficult to analyze the subject. It is very difficult to make focus while doing the research, to divide it according to make categories, measurement, analysis, and or even for prediction. It is very difficult because of the complexity of the topics that exist in the social sciences. So that makes it difficult to apply the techniques of experimentation. So because in experimentation is easier in science research, but it is a little bit difficult in social science researches. Then also we may face problems with the respondents. The respondents may refuse to cooperate with the researcher, or they may their improper understanding of the questions by the researcher is another problem. Then their loss of memory. Then their reluctance to furnish the certain information. So sometimes they can give the wrong information, and all these affects the research results and the data that we collected. So that is another problem. Then again, we can see that the problem of anthropomorphization, which is actually the person, the researcher himself tried to personify the human beings. So he can sympathize with them. And sometimes it also affects the results in his research. And also the sheer intuition of empathy can also arise from anthropomorphization, so which may even affect the conceptualization of the topic. The conceptualization process may affect because of this attitude. Then also the wrong decisions taken by the researcher, even from the time of selecting the topic, and also while creating the objectives, while creating the hypothesis, when operationalizing the concepts, then selection of the sampling techniques. In all these steps, we can see that the decisions of the researcher is very important. And if there is any wrong decision is taken, that also results in huge mistakes that on the data that we collected and finally upon the result too. So the researcher must be very precise while doing all these steps in the research. He has to keep the accuracy in all these steps, but it's very difficult to bring some kind of 100% accuracy like that in the science research. It's very difficult to keep this accuracy. Then also these ethical dilemmas may also arise while doing the social science research, because normally there are four types of ethical dilemmas may arise. One is actually in relation with those of sponsoring the research. If some sponsors are there, the researcher has to act in accordance with the sponsor's interest, which may affect the objectivity of the result. Then also relations with those of permitting access to sources of data. If some permissions are necessary for getting data from somewhere, then the permitting agency can impose certain restrictions on it. So that can also affect the objectivity and the researcher's freedom. Then also his relationship with the investigators connected with the project. Sometimes if it is a team, a group of people works together on a research, then others' interest may also affect. Others' interests also have to be taken into consideration. And so everybody's interest may not be the same. So then also the relationship with the research subjects themselves. If the person belongs to the same community, the researcher belongs to the same community, then a community or the society, the same culture he actually belongs, that can also create some kind of issue. So the reality may not come out, and he may not be interested in finding the reality and like that. So these are all the different types of limitation that social science research faces, and out of these limitations or challenges, bias is a major threat to all social science research. And so bias is considered to be one of the major limitations. So that is why when social sciences, whether social sciences can create general laws of social development like natural sciences is actually rest upon the question whether it can solve the problems of objectivity. So only when we do the research with an objectivity on them, we can depend the results actually it brought in. Then so there are many ways in which the objectivity may lose because many reasons, many aspects are there. So the first is actually a social scientist or researcher being a part of the subject matter. Then if that happens, then if the topic itself is part of the researcher's life, then that can also give, given a kind of misinterpretation or by the researcher himself. Then the researcher sometimes may have self-interest in the outcome of result if he or she is having some kind of personal interest or some self-interest to obtain, then that can also affect the consequences of the result. A prior assumption of the researcher, if the researcher has a prior assumption or a prejudiced kind of mind, a prejudice is there, then this also may result in some problems. Then research is born out of a researcher's personal inclinations or interest in a particular field. Then he may not be interested to do research in another area. And he is always sticking on a particular area can also create some problem. Then researchers' perception may be blurred by the cultural norms, beliefs and ideas. This is about his biasness because he may not be free from the cultural norms and the beliefs which is actually set in his mind. So this can all affect the objectivity. Doing the research without objectivity, then his or her impartiality may lose, and he or she may tend to get involved with the observed. So when observation is going on, he or she can sometimes think that I'm also part of the society. Then that may affect the in observation process itself. Then usually the social situations that and the institutional parameters always advocates for a status quo in the society. Nobody wants to change the social norms and the culture that exists in the society. And the researcher also sometimes forced to do on the same topics, or he may not be interested to bring the kind of reality which is often hidden in the society. So he always tried to bring some kind of soft evidences and data instead of digging out the harsh data. That is another problem. But at the same time, we can see that there are many methods, there are many ways that through which we can attain objectivity in social sciences, among which the patience and self-control is the first one. And if the researcher is having at most patience, then from selecting the topic onwards, he or she should not be overwhelmed by personal likes and dislikes. Then and also undisciplined imagination and wishful thinking, all these can affect his research. So he has to be very patient in selecting the topic and also formulating the problem. Then again, creating hypothesis in every step, he or she has to show the self-control. Then also, an open mind is again another necessity, or which can also help in bring some kind of objectivity in while doing the research. And he should be ready to bring the truth from the society, the reality from the society. For that, he should have an open mind without any bias and prejudices. Then also he can use some standardized concept that already existing in his or her subject, which actually helps them to create the problem in an effective manner. Even the hypothesis is objective, all these can set according to the existing concepts, and also the theories can also use in this stage, which all helps him to eradicate the the factors which affect the objectivity. There also use of quantitative method. Normally, for this quantitative research is considered to be more objective than that of the qualitative research in social sciences, because while doing quantitative research, a number of mathematical and statistical techniques are using to analyze the data, and even before analyzing the data, even at this time of sampling and while this, when sampling methods are collected, different methods can be used from statistics and mathematics, which ultimately help to bring some kind of objectivity. But in qualitative research, bring this kind of objectivity is very difficult, and that is why qualitative method is suggested instead of qualitative method. Then cooperative research can also bring some kind of objectivity, because if a group of people are there, then all these team members may not be the same objective. So they can discuss the topic together, and they can create a number of objective and hypothesis as a result of discussion. So this can also bring some kind of objectivity, because the bias of one person can be noted by the other, and that can be corrected at this point. So this is that is benefit of this cooperative research or the team research. So a group is involved in this research. Then use of random sampling. The random sampling is also very good to bring objectivity. Because when random sampling is used, we can't use our prejudice or biased mind while selecting the sampling. If we want to select some particular samples for the research, which may become very difficult when we do the random sampling. So these are all the different methods that we can see in used by the researchers to bring objectivity in social sciences. So we can conclude that objectivity in social sciences is not an achievable task as before 20th century. But from 20th century onwards, we can see that there are a lot of research which actually happens in social sciences. It is much better, or it's with much objectivity compared to the past researches, and which actually brought good results. Which can apply in the society, or which can apply in the on problems of the society, and that is why the results of this social science research has equal applicability and validity compared to that of the science researches. So social sciences starts equally competing with that of science research because of its objective nature from 20th century onwards. Thank you.